welcome to this month's Being in Sync Vibe. I am Kiana Sage, and today I am talking all about boldly stepping out in your career with confidence. So, as many of you know, I work with very high executives and management, and they do things a little bit different than the rest of the folks. So, one of the things that I want to talk about is what makes certain executives more successful and confident than others, and what makes them able to boldly step where others haven't gone before. What is that? Well, the truth of the matter is that what we believe about ourselves and the possibility makes it so. So our belief in our focus, in our attitude, and even the pace in which things are going really makes a difference. Like for me, I know I like things to move rather quickly. But when I'm working with a group of people, we all have to come together. You know, we all have to do the learning together and kind of go through the stages together. When I'm working with people one-on-one, you know, I adjust to the pace of the client. So, executives also have their own pace, and that pace determines a lot of their confidence, in my experience. So, one of the things that I wanted to do today is give you some things to start looking at your job or your career or your current position that you can start to look at and see, well, what is it that I need to adjust? Because just by being curious and raising your awareness, you can begin to adjust and suddenly shift what you believe is possible for yourself. And even see if where you're at resonates for the kinds of moves that you want to make for who you're becoming as a leader or as an executive. So what I thought I would do today is give you some very specific areas to look at, and then I'm going to share a story of an executive that I think will help tie these all together. And then I want to give you an update on what's going on with Donation Monday and how I'm shifting that moving forward, because I still have a lot of people coming into Donation Mondays and asking for some services and some help, which I have no problem offering, you know, new clients a donation to try it out and also experience something new. But I think some people are struggling with what is my next, you know, what can I even shift energetically? So I want to talk about that. So let's go back to our beliefs about our job. And I want to talk about seven different areas which you can start to get curious about what your beliefs are about that. So when you think about how my business is going to grow, so if you have goals and ambitions to grow, whether you're an entrepreneur or in sales or even manufacturing, it doesn't matter. If you're looking to expand your business, what are your beliefs about expansion? So for example, if you believe like, well, the economy's tight, nobody's coming into business, then that belief system is going to dictate how you move forward in your business. And that's going to also dictate how you're seeing the possibilities of expansion. And it's going to dictate your focus, attitude, and pace. So imagine if you have such a limited perspective, like, the economy's tight, people aren't investing in leadership development, for example. Well, then how much leadership development clients am I going to have? You know, so if I approach my business in that way, I would be very slow, right? And I would be kind of trudging through things. And I think people would get a sense of that. So you want to look at how are you looking at expansion within your business. The other thing you want to look at is your coworkers. Like, how is it that you're viewing your relationship with your coworkers? Is it arduous? Do you like them? Do you not like them? Do they like you? Do you have a difficult time with your boss? What are your beliefs about those relationships? Because that dictates how those relationships grow and foster. What is your belief about your job? Is it a dead-end job? Is it even serving your desires for coming to work every day? Do you believe that it's the right place for you? Those kinds of beliefs really play out in your day-to-day job. Is your job or career really feeding your purpose in life, your reason for being here? Those are great ways to look at your job and what it is that you believe about work. The other thing is about, what are your beliefs about rest and taking vacation? Do you feel guilty when you're at rest? Is there some undertones of beliefs that need to be looked at, be more curious about? Like, what is it I believe about vacation? Do I even believe I earned a vacation? Do I believe that I'm worthy of a vacation? And do I want to go on vacation? Or do I just think I have to take vacation? And if I take a vacation, am I going to miss out on something at work? Is somebody going to screw something up and then I'm going to have to go fix it? So therefore, I don't take a vacation. Or am I on quarantine? So why take a vacation anyways and use up those days when I can't go anywhere? Like, what is your belief about taking rest and vacation? How are your goals fitting into your work? So do you have goals at work? Are they even realistic? Do they resonate? Do you like them? Are you in resistance of them? What is going on with those things? I have found with many clients, there's a lot of just trying to survive. Forget about a goal. They just want to get through. And that's kind of a belief that's an undertone that you want to look at. The other thing is that you want to look at is the environment. What kind of working environment are you in? Even though you might be doing telework, there's still a work environment. And is that work environment, do you believe it's fostering your growth? Do you believe it's limiting your growth? Do you believe it's toxic? So these are all kinds of questions that you can begin to ask yourself about what it is that you're doing in your career that will be able to help you uncover if that's really true. So you can question it like, hey, is this really what I believe? And is that true? Because you got to be able to question your thoughts, right? Because not everything we think is true. And then have fun with it. Don't get mad at it. Don't be serious about it. But really go into reflection and contemplation about the path ahead, because these things are at play with your joy and your love of life and whether you're making a difference. And with that, I want to share a story about a client that I worked with that's in sales, and they were making good money, six figures at their career. And when they started to get real and question some things, like about, you know, the types of people they wanted to work with, who they were working with, how they were being positioned within the organization, just didn't fit for this particular client. They were making good money. There was a little bit, I will suggest, maybe a lot of fear of taking that leap of faith into something new, which they ended up doing. So they ended up leaving a very healthy, nice job to start a new position in a new company at 100% commission. So what does that mean? That means you start from scratch, you have no income coming in. And they take a risk of maybe not making that same kind of money. And yet, what do they get? They get a healthier environment, they start fresh, They become who they want to be. They have more freedom, more flexibility, more joy. And guess what happens? They have more than quadrupled the amount of money they were making before. And why? Why would that be? Is it just because they're just a stellar salesperson? And I think, yes, they love what they do. But they didn't before because they're doing the same, they're in the same line of work and they're not making nearly as much money or having as much fun. So I will challenge you all to look and see how much are you enjoying what you're doing? Is the environment so toxic that you couldn't flourish? And I think environment is really important to look at because it's something that we overshadow. Like, I can get through anything, and we push through and we trudge through. But really, our beliefs about the people we're working with and how they treat us really make a difference. Now, one thing I will tell you that was very interesting about this particular client is they had a problem with a coworker at the one organization, and they went to the next organization, and within a short period of time, it was as if the same issue showed up with this different employee, but still the same type of personality. And what I will tell you is that when we have lessons that need to be learned, they show up over and over again until we learn, until we change, one, how we believe about them, and two, how we're reacting to them. So, challenged his beliefs on this particular employee or coworker, and he changed his response completely, and it's not in play. It doesn't affect them. It doesn't affect how he works. It doesn't affect how much money he makes. It doesn't affect him in his personality, and he enjoys his job. Whereas in one situation, it was ruining the whole work environment and really eating him up, which is really a significant reason why he wanted to jump ship from one place to another. And then he goes to the next place and it's a very similar situation. So the point is you gotta look at and be curious about your beliefs about what is going on. So if you didn't learn your lesson in one place, you're gonna get it in another. But the beauty is that if you're willing to explore those things with somebody like me, you can transition so much easier and really thrive in what you're doing. So your attitude, your pace, and your focus will completely change when you are willing to look at these areas. So I really encourage you to have fun with this process and be curious about what is it that you believe. And you can take this whole list that I gave you about work and apply it to every area of your life, to family, should you be daring enough, to your friendships, to your networking. You can really apply this thing called how we get curious about beliefs and how do we make bold moves and really apply it to everywhere in our life, because our inadequacies of challenging our ways of doing things and really looking at how we are behaving really is our limitation. And those people who take big risks always get big rewards. And they're confident because they step out of their comfort zone and they look at things that don't fit anymore. They don't resonate. They don't make sense in their lives. And they do that on a regular basis. More often than not, they have somebody like me in their life who is helping them to look at those things. So let me know if you need help with that. The other thing that I want to talk to you about is Donation Monday and what's going on with that. And it's been really a joy to meet new people and have new people come into the Being in Sync tribe and to really explore life in a unique way. With that said, this next month, April, Donation Monday, I'm going to have two primary themes that we're looking at. One is how do we draw in energy so we're not having to trudge through things so difficultly, so life can be easier. And the other topic is how do you let go of the old? Like, that seems to be a real challenge for people. And it's right in line with the topic for today. You know, if you want to be confident and if you want to take bold moves, you got to be willing to let go of the old and really find ways to draw in energy, to really feel the vitality that you have within your body and within your life and enjoy it. So I welcome you to try out a Donation Monday session if you haven't. And also, please, all my work is done by referral. So if you like this video, please subscribe and share it with those in your network that think it would be helpful for them. And I will see you next month in the Being in Sync vibe. Bye-bye.